for Daddy Peppa's called the GP, and we're heading to the hospital now. There, they'll see what's wrong with you. Is that okay, sweetheart?
5-year-old Benicio suddenly became very short of breath during the night. The general practitioner thought it wise for him to go to hospital in order to be examined.
Please follow me. You can lay your son on the bed. I've already raised it a little because he doesn't look so well. I'm going to put him on the monitor so that I can check his oxygen levels.
I'll have a look too. Say hello first. Hi, I'm Femke. What's your name?
Benicio.
Hi. Hi, pediatrician. Hi. Well now, you're having a hard time. How long's it been like this?
Tonight he started to become very short of breath.
Okay. And yesterday? Fever?
No fever.
Was he coughing?
Yes, he was coughing a lot.
Had a cold?
Yes, that too.
How long's that been going on?
Almost a week now.
In the emergency department, the doctor is examining Benicio. She asks what preceded the shortness of breath and considers what may be the problem.
He's having to work quite hard. Let's listen to your back.
After the examination, the doctor reaches her conclusion.
Okay, what I hear sounds like an asthma attack. That means that the airways are being contracted, which of course makes it difficult to breathe. We can treat that with medication. What the medication does is make the muscles around the airways relax so you can breathe in and out more easily.
I'm going to give you a medicine that will make you feel a little better again. The medicine is in here. I'm going to put it on this and place this mask over your nose and over your mouth.
Benicio will be given medications to treat his shortness of breath. These will start working quickly so that he will be able to breathe more easily.
Here we go. 1, 2. Gently in and out. We're going to do this 10 times.
The doctor wants to observe him for a few more hours, so Benicio has to spend the night in the hospital. Asthma is an incurable lung disease that you have to learn to live with. It is a disease which requires lifelong intake of medicines. And this is done through inhalation. Provided you take the medicines in the right manner, you need not suffer much from asthma.
Benicio needs to puff again. Shall I do it the first time? And do you do it the second time?
Yes, that's okay.
Benicio, you need to puff again. Come and sit up straight. Yes. Shake it well. Then we put it in, put it on your face so nothing can get out. Look at the yellow valve. If it goes up and down, the mask is on right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Very good. Would you like to try now?
Yeah. Shake it first.
Yep.
And then a single press.
Yeah, never twice.
Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Day and night we inhale air through the lungs. If we are not short of breath, this is done automatically. During an asthma attack, however, you become short of breath as less air reaches the lungs than necessary for your body. When you breathe, the air passes to your lungs via your airways, a type of tubes. During an asthma attack, the muscles surrounding these tubes tense up. This causes the tubes to become thinner, allowing less air to pass, so that it is like trying to breathe through a straw. Apart from that, in case of asthma, the airways are often inflamed and swell up on the inside. This also causes the tubes to become narrower.
Good morning. Good morning. I've come to collect a prescription. It's for your son, is that correct? Yes. It's the first time.
Yes, it's the first time.
Then the pharmacist will give you an explanation. Take a seat.
Okay, thank you.
Well, these are the medicines that need to be inhaled. This is called an inhaler. This comes with it. It's called an inhalation chamber. I'll explain how to use it in a moment. So these are the two inhalers your doctor prescribed. As you can see, they're similar, but they're a different colour. I'll start with the red inhaler. It contains a sort of medicine that protects the lungs. If your son inhales this medicine twice a day, for example in the morning and in the evening, it'll prevent him from getting short of breath. And it'll stop him from having another asthma attack, which could cause permanent damage to the lungs. So it's very important to prevent these attacks. So you have to use this medicine twice a day, even if your son isn't short of breath. This is really important to know. The blue inhaler, this one, contains a medicine that widens the lungs. That makes it easier for air to get into the lungs so you feel less short of breath. So you can use it if your son still gets short of breath in spite of using the red inhaler. And it doesn't protect the lungs, it only temporarily reduces the shortness of breath.
The red medicine treats the inflammation and protects the lung from new inflammations. Therefore, your child has to take this medicine always, even when it is not short of breath. You use the blue medicine when the child is short of breath. It relaxes the tensed-up muscles surrounding the airways. The medicine quickly dilates the airways, giving your child more air. Sometimes, a medicine to prevent inflammation and a medicine to dilate the airways are combined in a single canister.
The blue inhaler starts working straight away, within a few minutes of inhalation. It lasts about 4 to 6 hours. And it should really have started working after half an hour. And the red inhaler only starts working after 1 to 2 weeks. So it takes a while to build up the protective effect, which will reach a maximum after 2 weeks.
Is it harmless to use the red inhaler on a continuous basis?
The thing is, this medicine is in a very low dosage. Also, it only reaches the lungs and not the rest of the body. That means there are very few side effects.
Hi, Benicio. I saw that your father and mother bought an inhalation chamber from the pharmacist. That's great. Shall we open it up?
The inhalation chamber should always be used when taking the medicines.
If you have a new one, you should wash it off in soap water first.
A new inhalation chamber always has to be washed off in soap water first. This soap water produces a layer on the inside and should therefore not be rinsed off. Never dry the inhalation chamber with a tea towel, but just let it dry in the air. It is the same as with a balloon that is brushed against something. Your hair is drawn to it. The same applies to medicines if the inhalation chamber has been dried with a towel. The medicine is drawn to the wall of the inhalation chamber and remains stuck there. The medicine does not reach the lungs then, and your child remains short of breath.
Let's take another puff.
Before Benicio is discharged, the inhalation is practiced one more time. Shake the medicine well before use and put the canister in the inhalation chamber with the canister turned upward. Make sure the child sits upright and place the mask of the inhalation chamber on the face. Check if the mask has an airtight fit on the mouth so that no medicine can escape. Have the child breathe calmly, count to 10. You can tell by the valves in the inhalation chamber if it goes well. They have to move along with the breathing.
8, 9. Well done, little man. You did a great job. Bravo. Okay.
Last night, Benicio was admitted to hospital due to his first asthma attack. He was very short of breath, but fortunately he's doing fine now and he may go home soon. It is, however, important to discuss the follow-up procedure, because asthma is, of course, an unpleasant disease, but can be treated well if you use the medicines correctly. Asthma is a self-care disease, which means that when you as parents make sure that your son takes his medication, his asthma will remain under control and you won't have to come to hospital anymore. Do you have any further questions?
No.
No? Then you can take Benicio home now. Benicio can go home again, and he is happy about that. At home, parents can do a lot to prevent new attacks. The main things at home to protect the child against an asthma attack are a dry and dust-free house, and the most important thing, never smoke in the house, nor when the child is not at home. Four-year-old Aisha has had asthma for a longer time. As a result of the medicines, she usually is hardly bothered by it. But there are always circumstances that can cause an attack. Not only is an asthma attack very unpleasant for your child, it can also damage the lungs. It is therefore important to see an attack coming and to prevent it by acting early.
Ah, hey, sweetheart. Are you not feeling well? No, here. Let me give you a hug.
Aisha has woken up short of breath in the night. Her parents check if they can find indications pointing to an upcoming asthma attack.
And she has a cold as well, a bad cold, right, sweetheart?
What are the indications you have to look for? How did your child sleep last night? Waking up wheezing or coughing is an indication and should be treated immediately. How did your child wake up this morning? A child that wakes up wheezing, coughing or panting should be treated.
Good morning, sweetheart. Are you feeling better now? Yes. Come.
Does your child cough, pant or wheeze when it exerts itself? In those cases, treatment is necessary too. In case of symptoms, it is also advisable to check the possible causes. The child has been in contact with a pet or a bird. Asthmatics can be allergic to animals. The child has a cold. Most asthma attacks start when a child has a cold.
And a nose drop? Come on.
The time of the year. In the spring, the air is saturated with pollen, and many asthmatics react to it with an asthma attack.
You need to sit up straighter. There you go. Against your pillow. Okay.
If symptoms point to an upcoming asthma attack, immediately administer the medicines prescribed by your doctor so that the attack does not continue. If your child has inhaled properly, she should soon feel better. If the blue medicine does not yet work after 30 minutes, you should call the doctor. Let the doctor hear your child's breathing over the phone.
Well done. That was very good of you, Aisha.
If you avoid the causes of an attack and administer the medicines on time, you can prevent asthma attacks. By doing this, you offer your child the opportunity to grow up carefree as children should. Keep this video and look at it again in case of symptoms, so you know for sure that you are doing things right and do not forget important points.
Ga ik deze over je neus en je mond zetten. Niet schrikken hoor. Kijk eens. Heel goed. Gaat ie. 1, 2. En rustig in en uit. En dan gaan we 10 keer doen.